Welcome back. This video will show you the left L5 and S1 nerve root block using ipsilateral oblique AP and contralateral oblique CM image guidance. I'll introduce the needle through the ipsilateral oblique image guidance. Then, rotate the CM to AP view. I can guess the needle depth and position with two different angles of the stereo views. I will turn the CM to contralateral oblique position for double confirmation. I rotate the CM as much as possible until I can see the clear profile of the cross section of the pedicle. Please remind the location of the pedicle and pathway of the nerve root in the left contralateral oblique image. Observe the L4 nerve root filling defects passing along the medial border of the pedicle. So, the nerve root will pass under the pedicle. This triangle looks like safe triangle on AP view. I will advance the needle under the contralateral oblique image. Please follow the needle tip. I will return to AP view. The needle tip is correctly located in the safe triangle. If my needle is placed in the right place, the contrast spreads to the transforaminal and epidural space. Keep this image in mind in the contralateral oblique image. Then, I will move over to the S1 nerve root block. I am turning the CM cranially and mild ipsilateral obliquely. The best way to find the posterior foramen of S1 is to find the pedicle of S1 and radiolucent hole adjacent to the inferior and medial border of the pedicle, and rotate the CM to the contralateral oblique position. Find the pedicle and yellow line below the pedicle of S1. It looks easy, right? Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.